Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Build a Better World Foundation kickoff celebration concert. All right. I'm Kai Kim, and I'll be your host tonight. It's honestly such an honor to be the spokesperson for Build a Better World Foundation, an organization dedicated to the betterment of humanity and committed to create awareness and raise funds to benefit organizations and products dedicated to children, youth, and people of the world. We do this through music, education, virtues and character building, empowerment, healing and wellness, human rights, sustainability, and the science and arts. Here to tell you more about the foundation is its founder, Christy Corwin.
We're so, so excited and so happy that all of you are here tonight with us to celebrate the launch of a long-time heartfelt dream of Gina and Russ Garcia, my grandparents. And we hope you will enjoy tonight and that you will be able to appreciate the talent and the capacity of these young people. And also, we are going to be presenting some organizations and projects that are very important and that we need to create awareness about and to raise funds for, to help support. So thank you so much. First, we're going to be showing our little video we just put together for Build a Better World Foundation, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Kim with Build a Better World Foundation, and here next to me is my special guest, Gavin Flynn. So Gavin, I'm going to ask you a question. How do you think the Earth is feeling right now with all these climate things? And
as humans, we need to protect the Earth, and right now we're doing a pretty bad job with all this pollution and stuff. I mean, it's not an easy job, but we can always try to strive to do better.
With all the terrorism going on, I think it's a little sad, maybe. And we need to try to fix that.
Probably just like taking it at little steps at a time, like ending like racism and probably stopping like wars. Yeah.
The Earth is kind of feeling happy and sad. Sad because we're polluting the Earth, and happy because that knowing that other kids and other people are happy most of the time.
I mean, there's definitely issues, but it's not as bad as, like, it's not, like, really, really bad. I mean, but it's going in a general direction where it could be pretty bad in it.
You know how I feel, blossom in a tree. You know how I feel, it's a new dawn, it's a new day.
What do you think we can do to make the Earth healthier and happier?
We could recycle, or we can do so much more by getting maybe yearly smog checks. That's a way for your cars.
No fighting.
Make poor people have a home and everybody lives happily.
Just be peaceful and we don't smoke, have wars.
Let this be our world.
Where we a better world mean to you?
To build a better world means to build a better community, a better neighborhood, a better country. That's what build a better world means to me.
To help people with stuff like that?
We could not pollute the air and just be peaceful.
Yeah, don't be a litter bug, kids. Pick up your trash.
It'd make me happy.
We are the color of the heart. We are a perfect work of art. Ooh, love is made in every shade of beautiful.
Dashing young man interviewing those people were. And now, for our second presentation of the evening, it's a powerful video by the one and only Michael Jackson, who understood the importance of us coming together as one to bring healing to our earth and the urgent need to build a better world.
What about sunrise? What about rain? What about all the things that you said we were to gain? What about killing fears? Is there a time? What about all the things that you said is yours and mine? Did you ever stop to notice all the blood we shed before? Did you ever stop this notice, this crying earth, this weeping storm?
Thank you.
Thriller. Yes, I know. I'm bad. And now, our next clip will be a media presentation by Full Circle Learning, presented by a board member named Stephanie Medina.
And we'd like to thank all of the live streamers that are watching from all around the world, New Zealand, New York, and other parts of the world. And we thank you so much for being here with us. And watching it via live stream. And thank you so much for your donations to buildabetterworldfoundation.org. We thank you so much for your support. And we need to really do, as you saw in that video, we have an urgent need for the planet right now to do good and to help to benefit many, many organizations that are doing good things. So thank you. We are so grateful to you for your support.
Thank you, Kai. Thank you, Christy. And thank you for including Full Circle Learning in this wonderful event. Utopia refers not to life in a perfect world, but to the pursuit of purpose in an imperfect world. Full Circle Learning helps young people apply their inner strengths and new learning to transform that imperfect world. Their teachers learn how to make service the goal of all learning, and to motivate that desire to serve on a basic belief in the oneness of humanity. Applying regional purpose to altruistic challenges. The recent outbreak of Ebola in Liberia left many casualties in its wake. In its aftermath, the number of orphans increased, unemployment rose to 90%, food became unaffordable for many. Through it all, people united to share their dwindling resources. They work together to meet the challenges of life in a challenging region. While practicing their habits of heart and applying their new skills, students tried to reduce hunger, conflict and corruption, gender violence, rape, and the selling of girls through childhood marriage. They worked to improve sanitation and health. They also taught adults how to use inner strengths to address outer challenges. In Liberia, full circle learning has become a movement in which the purpose of education is both personal and community transformation. The organization began its work globally in 1992 and has now touched down in 29 countries. It has gained strength in Liberia since 2009. Full circle learning customizes capacity building for teachers in each region. Those in rural Liberia want to be part of this movement. They have heard that the teachers' inspiration and strategies are helping their country return to its pre-Civil War values. The students embrace the role as society's humanitarians and change agents, not just locally, but globally. In 2012, a Los Angeles school conducted a hand-washing campaign to prevent outbreaks of the deadly flu virus. They challenged Liberian schools to also conduct a public health campaign. These students launched their campaign with homemade pillowcase flags. 2 months later, when the Ebola epidemic broke out, they knew the simplest key to prevention, hand washing. At that point, the teachers in 31 participating full circle learning schools went into high gear, even though the government required all schools to close for an entire school year. As volunteers, they distributed prevention flyers, food, Clorox, and other hand-washing supplies to all students. Some started Ebola-proof mobile classrooms. The mobile school teachers knew they could not allow children to touch or offer physical affection, but they taught steadfastness. The students learned to spell the ingredients in hot pepper soup and then made soup for their neighbors. They had to step around corpses in the street to deliver the comfort food. By the time Ebola subsided, the teachers had successfully prevented outbreaks among every student in 31 schools practicing full circle learning in Liberia at that time. As a result, 51 more schools have asked for full circle learning programs. They too want to bring about education as community transformation. This meant stretching our resources. Meanwhile, when school resumed, jobs did not. Food scarcity and prices went up. Students interviewed food vendors in the marketplace about how to bring down the price of commodities so everyone could eat. As they strive to address its challenges, the schools accept new orphans, hoping to care for their many needs. Many teachers still need training, mentorship, books, planning materials, and fees for orphans. While 17,000 students have been served this year, more than 2,100 classrooms in Liberia alone are still on the waiting list. Some of these lie in rural areas where students have had little access to education. They await our help funding orphans as well, since even public schools are not free. The children apply their skills toward improving the destiny of the human family. The teachers who guide them respond to a noble calling. True charity means giving every child and every teacher that chance to build a better world. Thank you for helping them reach for nobility.
Wow, what a powerful message. Truly. Our next performance comes from the one and only Agera High School Jazz Combo. This is an ensemble made up of members of the Agera High School Jazz A Bands and Studio Jazz Bands. It includes Jay Nelson on the saxophone, Michael Moss on the trumpet, Matthew Cooperberg on the piano, Henrik Zhang in the bass, and Maverick McMillan on the drums. The AHS Jazz Bands have participated in numerous events, including the Monterey Next Generation Jazz Festival, the Essentially Ellington Festival, and the Swing Central Jazz Competition. Agera High School has a nationally recognized music program, including 2 string orchestras, 3 wind ensembles, 4 jazz bands, 2 choirs, a madrigal group, some jazz combos, and a partridge in a pear tree. All AHS ensembles practice as a class 4 to 6 hours a week. The only thing paid for by the districts are the teachers' salaries. That's why it's so crucial to support the music boosters to ensure the students' musicians' success. The music boosters pay for everything from new chairs and stands to music and instruments repairs. The clinicians and specialists, they graciously thank the support of the Build a Better World Foundation for their donation. And I know Russ would be very proud to know that donations are going to youth musicians. They'll be playing Summertime and Imagine.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Agera Jazz. That was simply amazing. All right, well, our next presentation comes from the Star School, Charter Elementary School east of Flagstaff, Arizona. This school serves the Navajo Nation and the surrounding rural area. Their vision is to create a joyful learning community in which members develop the character, skills, and attitudes for understanding themselves, living in balance, and serving all our relations. They promote self-reliance, alternative building methods, and energy resources such as solar and wind power.
Thank you. And my daughter Capri and I had the privilege of visiting this school, and it's an absolutely amazing school. It's one of the top green schools in America and one of the leaders in self-sustainability. So it's a very special school in leading in that capacity. And they were wanting to be here tonight with us, and we were so sorry they weren't able to make it, but they made a special little short video for us, and we'll watch that right now. Thank you.
Hi, everybody from the Star School. We are building a better world right here. Thank you for your partnership.
Hi, everyone. We're Mark and Kate Sorensen.
We are the co-founders of the Star School.
The Star School is the first off-grid solar and wind-powered charter school in the country.
We serve Navajo students at the southwest corner of the Navajo Nation outside of Flagstaff, Arizona.
This is proof that we are able to build a better world together. This first building was built on the site of a junkyard, 10 miles away from any public utilities. We financed it with personal credit cards. We did what it took to get started, but our bigger dream depends on a shared vision.
At Star School, we believe it's our responsibility to give our children the latest in technology for education, the latest in the most dynamic tools we can teach with. This includes understanding and using the latest in brain research. So we would like your help in providing our students with brain education.
This is the beautiful Zadi Healing Garden, which was built with donations. It's the beginning of our efforts to provide a place for the community members to come together and heal all four elements of human life: physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual.
We appreciate your interest and support for the Star School. We hope you'll come and visit us someday.
Wow, they're just a bunch of wonderful people. I give them a gold star. All right, now we have a short clip on brain education.
Oh, first we have a star energy video by the same school, Star School. And it was made by one of the students about the school. And so we want to go ahead and play that video now. That short clip they just sent us because they weren't able to come, but they sent us that, so it just came in.
Wow. Lightning round entries, I suppose.
So anyway, we'll watch the Star Energy video that was made and created by one of the students at Star School, and then we will do the video on brain education.
I just used my star pun, so I'm going to have to think of another one.
Shining forever, ladder to heart, start to laughter. You have a way of making this better, better for me, for you, forever.
The Star School
is the first totally off-grid, totally solar-powered charter school in the country. Our whole system, including not only our electrical power for our computers and the kitchen and all the equipment we have, not only is that all powered by the solar system, but our well and our pump that powers all the water coming to our school is also powered by the solar system with help from the wind generators. The property, when we bought it 10 years ago, was actually an old junkyard. And we bought it because it was right next to the reservation and we wanted to serve families from the reservation. But it had no power lines and no water lines coming to the land. We decided the only way we could do a school is if we had it solar powered and if we did our own well. And that's what we did. We generate every day between the solar panels and the wind generators, we generate almost 40,000 watts. That makes us a mini power plant. The solar panels work in this way. So the sun's rays come down here, it excites all these electrons move here, and it creates movement of electrons, and that's what creates electrical power.
You have a way of making this better for me, for you, forever.
The wind turbines operate just like your engine turns the alternator around, and that creates power that charges up your battery in your car. That's the same way the wind turbines work. The system that we have, it has a remarkable feature, and that is it records how many pounds of carbon dioxide we have saved the planet. Rich and we don't have a whole lot of resources, if we can set up our school to be powered on solar, then I think other schools could too.
Not travel far to listen to your town.
For real this time. Now we have a short clip from Bridge Education.
And in 2007, I had the privilege of starting with the Brain Education program and being trained in Brain Education as an instructor. And it's a wonderful program that's being implemented in schools, primarily in New York right now, but all over the country. And we'd like to share this video with you. Part of the funds that we are wanting to raise is funds to train the teachers in brain education at the Star School in Flagstaff, Arizona. So please enjoy the video regarding brain education. And it is science-based, and you'll get a real good idea for what it is from the video. Thank you.
What happens when you combine top neuroscientific research with mind-body exercises and mindfulness training? The result? Power Brain Education. Over the last 8 years, Power Brain Education has worked with more than 350 schools nationwide to train more than 10,000 teachers and 30,000 students in mindfulness and neuroplasticity. Power Brain Training is a unique and exciting mix of physical, emotional, and cognitive exercises. These exercises mutually guide students and educators to create the optimal environment for improved focus, confidence, memory, creativity, and emotional well-being.
To me, what distinguishes the BE for Enhanced Learning program is that it integrates all the different layers of a child's well-being, their physical well-being, their emotional and behavioral attributes, and then their higher faculties, so-called, including cognition, and their way of thinking, and their higher academic achievement. The genius of that approach is to really integrate all of those layers so that we can get the full well-being of the child, their self-efficacy, and their confidence, and their ability to do really just about anything. This graph shows that the children in the BE group had more emotional self-management, better concentration, and improved overall learning efficiency compared to those in the control group.
We also collaborate with client schools to assess the personal needs of their students and develop individualized instructional plans to maximize student achievement. Our brain education teaching workshops equip teachers with hundreds of hands-on exercises and activities that can be easily integrated into the school day. For example, we provide effective exercises that wake up the students' brains or relieve their stress before taking a test.
Mm-hmm. It's been helping me to get more focused and also to get more relaxed for a state test.
The pinky exercise, it's kind of hard.
Some of my students on a daily basis who sometimes lose focus, I've seen them doing the pinky thumb, which I'm still working on. And they've noticed that that helps them remain focused. If they need a break, they take the time out to do that exercise.
I think it's really fun, and I think it helps me with a lot of tests.
As a professional, I've noticed that when I'm calm, the kids are calm. So if we take that 5 minutes to do the power ball, energy ball, and to just calm down and be like one together, the kids will calm down and be in a more focused place.
Our neuroplasticity and mindfulness trainings include simple breathing and meditation techniques. These methods help students strengthen their attention span and utilize the creative power of alpha brainwaves. We also offer informative and engaging parent workshops to help parents reinforce and strengthen the power brain skills their children have learned in class.
They could see the benefits of having a program such as Power Brain at our school to support the students. And we began by supporting our students in third through fifth grade with the focus primarily being on remaining focused, staying stress-free during high-stakes testing. And it really took off, and there's such buy-in from the teachers, from the students, and because of that, it's actually growing school-wide. The PTA has brought Power Brain in to support our lower grade students so that they can implement these strategies from an earlier age.
It's not a program about conversation and theory. It's about doing. We found out immediately that those teachers who were implementing brain education in the classrooms, they have better classroom management. The kids were a lot happier. Also, through brain education, I was able to engage not only the teachers and the students, but also the parents and members of the community. We're teaching them about the brain operation system, which is a when you choose, it will happen. Wake up, pay attention, you know, and good news makes a good brain.
How is this right? How is this side? How is
this down? We started brain education after my second year as a principal. I have conversations with my teachers and my staff. Everybody will agree that this is a happier school. A great amount of the kids that have graduated from PS1, we constantly hear the parents saying how well they're doing in middle school and how well they're doing in high school. So now we have kids that have returned from middle school and high school that the principals from those schools are now saying, I don't know what you're doing at PS1, but we want the kids from PS1. And what I realized was that when you transform a school, you can also transform the community. So that was very powerful to me, because when I began to see that when you change a school, you can also change the community. And I began to see parents behaving better. And I began to see visitors behaving better. And I began to see a transformation. Then that inspired me to be a principal. And so I said, you know, once I become a principal, now my goal is to use the school to change not only the community, but also the world.
The ultimate goal of Power Brain Education is to help all of us tap into the limitless potential of our brain. We hope you found our video to be informative and inspiring. Let's work together to create health, happiness, and optimal achievement for your school community. For more information, please visit our website at powerbraineducation.com.
All right, well, I hope you got some brain education out of that wonderful performance and or presentation. Our next presentation comes from ECO, or Earth Citizen Organization, as they develop leaders committed to making a difference in their lives and communities for a healthier and sustainable world.
And the Earth Citizen Organization, I've been able to have the privilege of going to one of their locations, the location in Sedona, Arizona. And they have a magnificent facility, and they're training young people all about sustainability, how to, in natural health, gardening, cooking, construction, everything they're teaching, so that they can go back to their communities and teach it to the people in the communities. And the president of the Earth Citizen Organization, Steve Kim, one of the things that he says that I really, it always stuck with me, is that we should always focus on our ultimate commonality and have unity in that ultimate commonality. So that's something that I've always appreciated that he has said. So here is a short video about the Earth Citizen Organization.
Earth Citizens Organization, also known as ECO, is a nonprofit that was formed in September 2013. We work to develop leaders committed to making a difference in their lives and communities, in the spirit of Earth citizenship for a healthier and more sustainable world. The name of the organization reflects our belief that we are all citizens of the Earth and share the responsibility as its stewards for the well-being and continuity of our planet and all of the life forms on it. ECO's focus has been on providing training and education, along with organizing community events that help people live mindfully and become healthier naturally. Through these actions, ECO desires to catalyze a shift that will change the future of the world to one of peace and sustainability. We call this collaborative effort the Earth Citizen Movement. Our goal is to reach 1% of the world's population, about 100 million people, and to help them incorporate Earth citizenship into their lifestyle and daily choices. So just what makes up an Earth citizen? An Earth citizen puts the Earth first. Earth citizens may do things such as carry their own reusable bags with them, not only to keep the environment clean, but to avoid the hundreds of years it could take for plastic bags to decompose. In fact, sticking to permanent items when you can, instead of disposables, helps in the same way. An Earth citizen cares about all people. Empathy is a daily practice for Earth citizens. We understand that all humans are precious and share the same global issues, which we cannot deal with properly without a mindset that cares for all people in all life forms. Our goal is to establish eco-national chapters in more than 100 countries by 2017. In each of these areas, we diligently work at reaching out to expand our community through activities such as workshops, trainings, events, and community services. An Earth citizen lives a healthy and self-sustaining life. Knowing that change starts from within, Earth citizens make it a priority to be mindful of their health and to lead a self-sustaining lifestyle. Taking the time to get adequate rest, meditating, being sure to smile, and keeping an overall healthy balance is essential. As an example, eating organic whenever possible is another action that not only an Earth citizen will benefit from, but the reduction in pesticides in growing the food is actually helpful to the land and environment, allowing it to regenerate more nutritional food. An Earth citizen takes action. Earth citizens understand that change will not happen without actually taking action. The best of ideas or intentions will mean nothing until action has been added to them. Therefore, we encourage initiative. For those wanting to leave their own mark, yet need some support in facilitating it, ECO encourages and assists in helping you to create an ECO club or initiate an ECO project. So whether you are looking for small, simple ideas on how to recycle, or wanting to head up a large-scale community outreach program, ECO is here to encourage your efforts. Never before has...
So, Steve Kim is the president of Earth Citizen, and you're Kai Kim. Do you think you're related?
My father's name is Steve Kim, and we also originate from South Korea.
You never know.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, well, our next performance comes from Annie Resnick, as she began performing publicly at age 5, and has been in over 50 productions since then. Her alternative rock and blues band, Clockwork City, has been writing and performing together for over 5 years. Their EP, for which all proceeds go to Shred Kids Cancer, a patriotic cancer research organization, is available on their Facebook page. Special thanks to Christy and the Build a Better World Foundation for making this concert possible. They'll be singing Imagine and Waiting on the World to Change.
Thank you. you so much. We are Clockwork City. That is the name of, it says Annie and the band in the program, but the band is called Clockwork City. I want to introduce the band over here on guitar. This is Jonah Goldstein over here. Give him a big hand. He deserves it. This guy on bass and backup vocals, this is Jack Severino.
What's up, guys?
Behind me, this is Alex Andrews on drums. Guy's a beast. And my name is Annie Resnick. I'll be your lead singer this evening. And yeah, we're really excited to be here. I was part of a similar project with Christy 4 years ago at the Canyon Club, and it's really amazing. Recently, a lot of people would say that we're going through a dark time, and what kind of gives me hope, and our country's going through a dark time, is that the reaction I've seen from youth in America really gives me a sign that things are going to be different in the future, and I think that was what that song was about, and this next song is about this too, I think, and I would love it if you sang along with me.
Nothing to die for, no lives to.
Thank you.
Alrighty, well, wasn't that just amazing? I would say it's show-stopping, but we have a second half coming up. But before that, we'll be taking a 15-minute intermission in between so you can prepare yourselves for the amazingness that is Charlie Bond and his band.
And we'll be having some more presentations as well. Thank you again to the live streamers who are watching. We're so grateful to you. And www.buildabetterworldfoundation.org. We appreciate your support. And upcoming in the next half, we will be having a performance of one of the songs from Gina and Russ's CD, musical drama, called The Unquenchable Flame. And we have the CDs available in the lobby, as well as the biographies of both Russ and Gina. Gina's biography is about their travels through the South Pacific for 6 years, stopping at all the islands and teaching the oneness of humanity through music. And Russ's biography is about his music life, and it's endorsed by Quincy Jones, and those are available in the lobby if you'd like to take a look. And we'll see you back here in 15 minutes. Thank you so much.